And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda Blind. I am the RPG Chick, and now we will actually starting the game. This episode should be a little shorter than the last one. And, yeah. Once again, this is the trial version, so the version you're playing, if you're playing later on, might be different in some ways. Okay, difficulty. Yeah, I'm gonna play normal. With experience playing shooters and RPGs. Subject to change, I'm definitely not going higher. Seeking the ultimate challenge. Casual, inexperienced narrative. More interested in story than combat. Which I actually am, but I know you guys like to see combat. I'd say over the series, 80% of the comments until the end, until like, you know, the Mass Effect ending, were just about combat, combat, combat. And I'm more about the story. So hopefully I can change one level down if this is a little tough for me, because I don't know. I want pause. I want, you know, it's basically real time with pause, you know. Only it's a manual pause, but now we don't have that. So hopefully there's no... Since the game is still downloading, I think. Hopefully there won't be any stutters and lag and such. Electronic Arts presents a Bioware production.
Every great moment in our history began with a dream. Each bold leap forward was achieved by those willing to do anything to attain it. We are, all of us, leaving behind families, homes, the very birthplace of our species. Some for discovery. To see the unknown. Others for a new start.
Not necessarily escaping the Reapers?
But today, whatever our reasons, we take the first steps toward a new future for
That's
humanity.
That's Cora.
Today, we begin to make our dream reality.
Right, so people have wondered if they're escaping this galaxy just in case the Reapers win. In year 2185, humanity lives in a golden era of interstellar travel. Our discovery of ancient alien ruins on Mars propelled our understanding of science and technology ahead by thousands of years. While many now enjoy the newfound freedom and challenges of exploration in the Milky Way, others look to even more distant stars. For the 100,000 adventurers embarking on this one-way voyage, the future begins in Andromeda. Please be awesome, story. Please be awesome. Cool. 634 years later. Date 0 hour, 0 day, I guess, after. From that time. We've got like a two-pronged spaceship here. We have lights activating. Ark Hyperion. Occupancy 20,000 human colonists. Including the Ryder family. Gotta say, the visuals so far are really awesome. Andromeda Galaxy, destination Habitat 7 in Helios Cluster. Now, I was wondering if I can go to other clusters, or we're just going to be relegated to this cluster. So we got the cryogenics bay. We've arrived, so everyone's going to wake up, I'm supposing. Forty-seven gigs, I believe, guys, to download this trial. There she is.
Deep breaths. You're gonna want to take it easy.
I've been taking it easy for 600 years.
Stuttering.
Ryder, Sarah, Recon Specialist, Pathfinder Mission Team.
Pathfinder Team, eh? The ones finding us a home.
Can you make it somewhere tropical? Nice, warm ocean, summer year-round?
How about we get her a cup of coffee first?
That's considerate. What if I don't like coffee?
The selection process saw the Andromeda Initiative evaluate thousands of potential habitable planets within the galaxy.
Sarah Ryder, let's get you checked out. Look here.
After discovering an unusually high ratio of potential candidates for golden worlds, the Helios cluster was selected as our destination. Now you are a part of the first wave of ARCs arriving in Andromeda, our new home for humanity.
Yeah. We're slow.
Makes it sound so easy, doesn't it?
Tone choice. Okay, I have a limited time here. Tone choices help define Ryder's personality. Emotional, logical, casual, or professional. And how do we... Okay. Alright, so instead of Paragon and Renegade, casual, professional. Easy is no fun.
I hope not. I signed up for a little adventure before we settle down.
Well, buckle up. Sounds like you'll get your wish.
Buckle up, buttercup.
Over here now, the Pathfinder wants you all on your feet right away. He said mission ready within the hour.
Any idea why?
No, but I'm guessing that's where your adventure comes in.
Indeed.
Okay, everything checks out. Just one more thing before I send you on your way. Let's test your SAM implant. Sam, are you monitoring?
Oh, that's that thing that...
Sam, are you online?
Yes, Dr. Tapero. Good morning, Sarah. Are you feeling well?
He's a VI implant, I think. Or AI. I'm not sure. I guess we'll find out. So this... We don't have casual, professional, emotional at all. My implant?
I just need a second to get my bearings. What's this about my implant?
A routine check. After being in stasis, we want to make sure the connection's still live.
As the team's mission computer, your well-being is my primary concern.
Assuming the implants work as advertised, Sam sees what you see, in theory. We won't know for sure until we get you in the field. How are you feeling otherwise?
I'm excited.
I'm ready to get to it.
Readings confirmed. I detect an increased level of adrenaline in your system. The neural implant is functioning properly.
Can't explore space without my coffee.
You're all done. Oh. Let's get you on your way.
So she does like coffee.
You may want to hang around while we revive your brother. It always helps to see a familiar face.
I don't like the sound of that.
Nor do I. Okay, so we just rammed into this thing. No one's watching where we're going. Okay, we've lost gravity.
What's happening? It broke free. Just hang on.
Engineering, report.
Try to brace yourself. I don't have anything to hold on to.
Careful of the
side. I'm almost inside. Hold on.
Okay, so alt is my look thing. Like the V in
this
Mass Effect.
I'm at the cryo bay.
Three.
Brace for a reset. Everyone okay?
Oh, God.
I think so.
Choppiness.
We're not sure. Sensors are scrambled. But it's good to see you're up. Feels like centuries since we spoke.
This is the Pathfinder. Mission teams continue preparations. Cora, Riders, report to the bridge.
You heard him. Let's get...
We have a problem over here.
Oh.
It's Scott Ryder.
He can't die. I spent like a minute and a half customizing that guy.
What's wrong?
Okay, now is when I Restart the recording. We have lag. Well, not lag, but, you know, choppiness. Oh, because the game's still installed. It actually shows you here. Pretty cool. So, my hope is that once this is completely finished, which is probably going to be, you know, I'll probably be asleep by the time it's done. But with episode 3, we won't have this choppiness, and that the choppiness is caused by this. Otherwise, I'm going to have to go into settings and try to mess around and minimize some things. While I'm in here, though, item limit 4 out of 50. So we have 4 items. What are those? Level 1. Report to the Hyperion Bridge. Optional. Check on your brother. I don't think that's really optional unless you really actually hate your brother. And not like most people hate their brothers and siblings. You really hate your brother. So I just want to look at the stuff. Cool. Prologue Hyperion. The interface is really snazzy and stuff, and the visuals are really nice. I'm just hoping the combat doesn't totally kick my ass, because I can't pause, and I hope the story is actually good into the game, not just now. It's pretty good. Meet your father, the Pathfinder, on the Hyperion's Bridge. Right, and he's voiced by... Crap, what's that guy's name? The guy who plays the Kurgan in Highlander. And he was in Starship Troopers, and he was in a bunch of movies. So that's our journal. Toggle tracked. Alright. Okay, so we're tracking this mission. So we have other missions. These are the missions of personal importance to the Pathfinder and the Tempest's crew. Loyalty missions are included in this category. So these are just... We go in there, okay. So we don't actually have missions here. This is just categories of missions. Wow, they've really broken this down. Many groups and individuals across the Helios cluster have asked for the Pathfinder's help. Really. Additional tasks may not be essential to the initiative's survival, but every bit helps. And completed missions, tasks, and activities. That's pretty neat. What is this? Not available? Codex. I like getting into Codex now. You guys will probably be pissed if I start reading Codex right now. Oh, the map! Cool! This is us, right? And we're facing that way. Oh, I get it. Tracked. We've tracked the quest, or mission, rather, so it shows you where it is on the map. That's why tracking is. Use mouse to pan around the map and wheel up down to zoom. Cool. And what's this? Information wall? That's the one that was talking. Alright. Okay. Caves? You got caves. Cave interest. Cave entrance, points of interest, structure. Alright. Journal. Map. Codex. We got stuff. Skills. Current loadout. We don't have any weapons right now. Barrier. So we have 0 points. We can't do anything right now. So I'm not going to really mess with it. This is not available. So I'm wondering, these two are going to be filled in by something. Alright.
Did the world just turn upside down, or am I still dreaming?
It left a nasty bump on your head. Let me take a look.
Dr. Carlisle.
First 5 minutes in Andromeda, and we're already crashing the car.
You thought
well,
it'd be easy?
No, but I figured any scars would wait till we land.
You're looking at me, not him. hostile.
Well,
he was looking at us.
Obvious contusions to your brain. Looks nice and pink. Wait, the cut's that deep?
Just kidding.
God.
Checking for a concussion. Your cognitive awareness seems okay.
Ah, right. Where'd you get your degree, Doc?
Joker University.
Don't let anyone be a doctor around here.
What?
Good. Your auditory response seems normal, too.
Haha. Nothing worse than a doctor with a sense of humor, let me tell you.
You're on the Pathfinder team, aren't you?
Yeah.
Then I'd say you've had enough. No time for pit stops.
Where's Liam? Over there. Oh, I gotta hold it in?
Enjoy your nap, Ryder. Don't think I'll need sleep for the rest of my life.
Maybe another decade or two wouldn't have hurt.
Right. Talk to you later.
Alright, so if I go...
Hey there! Hell of a wake-up call, huh? Didn't expect that first thing out of stasis.
Makes two of us. Hang in there.
I want to zoom into him more, but I don't think I can do that.
Gravity loss means something tripped the generators.
Like what?
Something big. Those generators are hardened. Take a hell of a lot to overload them.
On the bright side, nobody's eaten in 600 years. No projectile vomiting to worry about.
Haha. These guys are funny. Kirkland.
Good to see you, Ryder. Sorry, still waiting for some coffee.
I think I got my coffee, didn't I? I can't talk to him.
Still getting used to it.
Report to the hangar.
Toronto.
Earthborn, huh? I'm a colony man myself.
Eden Prime.
Eden Prime!
You had some trouble there, didn't you? Fighting?
Yeah.
Yeah. I lost some friends.
It's a sovereign.
Figured it's time for a fresh start.
Well, welcome to your new life, eh?
Very neat. Bringing things full circle, referencing the first game in this new series. Fisher.
Morning, Ryder. Or afternoon. Or, I don't know.
Eternal Night of Space.
Damage control team to deck 3.
It's basically what it is. Eternal Night of Space. Alright, so we can't talk to these people. Who's this?
This looks broken.
You got broken?
First hour in Andromeda, and I'm on cleanup duty.
Life's tough, isn't it? Can we pick anything up? We've got a medkit here, I can't take that. So you still grab medkits, you know. So... I'm trying to hear... They talk a lot. I'm trying to hear all conversations here. Oh my. I know how to interact.
Physical integrity looks good.
What's Cora? I can't talk to Cora? Cora Harper.
There. The power cycle is green.
No structural damage to the pod. All connections check out.
Cora Harper, it's just a bad time.
Dr. Tapero.
An interruption in the respiratory cycle, maybe.
Interesting how we can't talk to her. Now they're going to keep talking, so I'm just pausing. It's Cora Harper. They revealed sometime after Mass Effect 3, I think it was part of the comic series, that the elusive man, I forget his first name, but his last name is Harper. So Cora is, it's either a red herring, which is going to piss a lot of people off, because they're going to be like, why? You know, why name her that? But she has the last name Harper, so she's related to him in some way. And this whole thing started kind of fuzzy. Somewhere around the beginning of Mass Effect 2, or before Mass Effect 2. Between Mass Effect 1 and 2. Something like this. So he was still around when they were sent out. So she could be his daughter, right? She could be his niece. Who knows? She could be... Who knows? Maybe she was... She's his ex. How the hell do we know? It's funny because you know, you always... You read these... it was on the what do you call it? The Shadow Broker vessel. Where you found out that, you know, they're observing the elusive man. And he's getting together with all these, you know... Attractive, like, rich women and stuff. 82%. So we're still downloading... So he could get involved with someone a lot younger than he is, so who knows? Let's talk to Dr. Taparo.
Sarah.
Is my brother okay?
Scott's fine. His vitals are strong, but the revival procedure was interrupted.
Cora Harper, report to the bridge.
Well, they're calling you, Cora. What's the prognosis?
When can he wake up?
We don't want to rush it. Sam?
My connection to Scott's implant was suspended. However, his pulse, respiration, and brain activity are all normal.
They're calling you,
to
Cora.
To be on the safe side, we'll need to keep him in a low-level coma for a while.
Oh, God.
Then let his body regain consciousness naturally. He'll be fine.
Glad to hear it.
Thanks, Lexi. Keep us updated.
Ryder, I'll wait for you at the door, whenever you're ready to go.
Well, I guess I'm going to the bridge, too. That's right, I do have to go to the bridge.
Keep them in the pod for now. Round-the-clock monitoring. We don't know if they're in true stasis anymore.
Right. So parts of the body could be waking.
Cora Harper, report.
But others aren't. We can't be sure just yet.
What about...
I can't interact with this stuff.
Run an intravenous line into the
pod. I can...
Standard nutrient package. See how their system responds.
Will do. I'll start slow and go from there.
And if necessary, add boosters to the line. We can't risk pulmonary arrest.
They really have a lot of conversations. I just want to hear it all. Sorry, guys. Cryopod.
Still in stasis. Vitals look good.
Wait, so he's in this one? That doesn't look like a human being could fit in there. Unless he's a lot shorter than I am. Alright, so... we're supposed to go that way. Who's this person? You're nobody important, and you're really furiously typing commands there. So the bridge is that way, apparently. Map? Alright. So then what... whoa. You're blinding me over here. What is this way? Hello. You guys alright?
Nice
oh.
And easy. Just take deep breaths.
She's the one with the cool hair.
Was that floating?
Yeah, briefly.
I had a little hiccup with the gravity.
That's what you call it?
What day? When is it?
It's been 600 years. We're in Andromeda. So far, so good. How do you feel?
Like I've got the world's worst hangover.
It's actually 600 and change. I forgot the exact amount.
So, your name's Lucas Greer?
It was when we left.
They need you on the Pathfinder
team. It changed?
Let's get you ready to go.
So soon?
Probably has to do with whatever knocked out the gravity.
Huh. Okay, I keep restarting to prevent some audio-video desync, because with stuttering like this, the audio keeps going and the video or graphics stutter, and you get the sound ahead of the, you know, the visuals.
Wow, that was weird.
Who's a settler?
I don't remember dreaming or anything. 1 minute I'm in the Milky Way getting ready to sleep. Next.
You're 2 million light years away.
No joke. We really flew that far?
We really did. Welcome to Andromeda.
I keep wanting to zoom in to see their faces better.
Got any food?
I'm starving. We'll start you with some liquid protein.
No pancakes?
Your digestive system hasn't handled solid food in over 6 centuries.
Yeah, that's all.
We need to
Right.
Not that long.
Man, just hearing that out loud. 6 centuries.
Yep.
All without pancakes.
What a shame.
What about liquid pancakes?
Ugh.
Sorry, it's mushy, milky stuff. Tastes like paste.
Well, you're not getting a tip.
Well, what do you think liquid pancakes would taste like? Not much better.
Sweet dreams.
So we don't know who's in there. So, I'm wondering if there's a setting that will change this. You know, the field of view, maybe? Because we have a lot of real estate up over her head. It's just, the character looks so small. I really like her outfit, though. You could see it better in the cutscene. Because you really can't see anything below the waist without going all the way up like that. What do we got down here?
Thank God nobody was in this.
Yeah, it's a good thing.
Engineering, this is Cryo Bay. We've got a pod that was damaged when we lost gravity. You'll probably want to send something over.
I'm hoping more interactivity with dialogue is coming. Okay, so I can run. Oh, nice. Look at that. Run. Whee. And jump. Can I jump? I can't jump. Oh, it's... I have it toggled. Alright. You know I'm probably going to change that. Oh, we got the data pad. Message from Captain Dunn. Attention, Hyperion personnel. After a 600-year voyage, they keep rounding it off. The good news is we're exactly where we're supposed to be. We have arrived in the Helios Cluster, Andromeda Galaxy, year 2819. All stasis medical personnel should report for duty immediately. Give the Pathfinder mission team revival priority and prep its members for field reconnaissance. Reports of an unusual celestial phenomenon in the cluster are being investigated. Updates to follow. Captain Dunn. Cool. I don't suppose I can highlight things. No, because that's easy to miss. So I did miss that. And I'm going to miss things. Message from Jen Carson. Garson, sorry. Hello, traveler, and welcome to your first day in Andromeda. Oh, thank you. This is the dawn of a new era for all of us. As you recover from stasis, know that you're in good hands. In a few short hours, you'll be leaving the Hyperion and joining thousands of your fellow colonists as you chase your fortunes and build the new life you've always dreamed about. It's been a long wait, but I promise you it will be worth it. Jen Garson, founder, Andromeda Initiative. I don't want to miss anything, but those are hard to spot, aren't they? Just gotta... The text is so small. A data pad there, and a data pad over there. And a Costa, and a... What about this? Can we look at this? Oh, we can... Okay, use it.
Hi there. I'm Gian Carson, founder of the Andromeda Initiative.
Oh, you wrote that
I'm
thing.
I'm here to welcome you to a whole new galaxy. The good news is... The hard part's over. We're here.
That's the hard part.
If you have any questions,
we slept through it.
Just ask.
Oh, we can ask all questions. What's our destination?
The selection process saw the Andromeda Initiative evaluate thousands of potential habitable planets within the galaxy. After discovering an unusually high ratio of potential candidates, or golden worlds, the Helios Cluster was selected as our destination. Now you are a part of the first wave of ARCs arriving in Andromeda, our new home for humanity. Once the Pathfinder team's assessment is complete, Habitat 7 has been selected as the most likely candidate for colonization.
That's the name of a planet, Habitat 7? Mission status.
At present, ARC Hyperion has arrived in the Helios Cluster. Further mission updates are offline due to technical difficulties. As recon specialist, you are tasked with supporting the authentication of Golden World sites through exploration, mapping, and scientific analysis. Currently, you are to report for duty on the command bridge.
I know. Tell me about Pathfinders.
The Pathfinder is responsible for exploring and assessing new worlds for outpost placement and settlement. Each ARC is led by a Pathfinder who represents their species. The active duty Pathfinder assigned to ARC Hyperion is Alec Ryder. Current duty roster shows you are assigned to the Pathfinder mission team, Specialist Ryder.
Clancy Brown. That's his name, Clancy Brown. Plays, well, does the voice of Alec Ryder, who is the father of the two twins here. Any other ARCs?
Your current location is ARC Hyperion, housing the human population. ARC Barchero, the Solarian vessel, confirmed departure in 2185. The Asari ship, Ark Lucinia, confirmed departure that same year, as did the Turian Ark Natanis, embarking in 2185.
Asari, Turian, and Salarian. All the council races. Now, I've been told there are Quarians. There are going to be Quarians, minimally. I mean, maybe the throne on one of the other arcs. I don't know. Which makes me happy because, well, the end of, by the end of, well, in Mass Effect 3 and by the end of Mass Effect 3 ended up the Quarians being basically all but killed off, except for a few stragglers who were probably died shortly after. I guess I played blind and I didn't know what was going to happen, of course, so don't blame me. And then ended up choosing the destroy option for Mass Effect 3, which killed off the, you know, Geth anyway. Why are these all great but we can choose this again?
The Andromeda Initiative encompasses all colonization efforts, including arcs, pathfinders, outposts, and the central support hub, the Nexus. The current location of the Nexus is unknown.
Okay.
Status of outposts are unknown.
There was more information. We've seen this.
I'm Gian Garson, founder of the Initiative.
Can we?
I think it's important we take a moment. It started with a life in Andromeda. Drop me a note sometime. I'd love to hear how we're doing.
Right, so you skip. Okay. That's it. Oh! Hayes? Hayes, you look cool.
It sounds amazing, doesn't it? Right up until you lose gravity.
She's got like a shadow or something. Right until you lose gravity. Does she say more things?
I've dreamed about this my whole life. I sure hope it matches the brochure.
Huh. Alright, she's done. So then we can say more to Dr. Tepero.
Don't worry, Ryder. We'll take care of him. He'll make it.
He better, Buster. Or there'll be hell to pay. So we can keep talking to these people when they have this selectable. Yeah, that was a meaningful... Okay.
See you around.
Yeah, that was worth selecting that again. Okay. Anyone else want to say see you later and stuff? Nope. Okay. Okay. Cora. We're finally going to move on. I think I caught all the data pads and talked to all the people. Let's go.
You ready?
What's
apparently.
Wrong?
You gotta serve the power readings.
Uh-oh. Oh! Oh. I can't leave.
Whatever hit the arc fried everything. We have to balance the power load or it can explode.
But we don't know where the fault is.
Investigate
Ryder
the mountain.
Ryder can find it. She has a scanner. Quick, Ryder, use it to locate the fault. On it. I'll try to get readings on the second conduit.
Hey, I'll try to run a diagnostic.
Okay, so here's the scanner thing.
We don't have much time.
Shit.
We can lose the whole cryo.
How do I
Ryder,
know when... Okay.
Try scanning the whole conduit. Look for the fault.
X here. No relevant data.
Hurry, Ryder. Find the fault.
Don't balance the current. We're
looking I'm hurrying.
Across the whole arc.
There's no indication of a fault in this component.
Keep looking.
This equipment is operating normally.
It has to be here.
Operating normally. Well, I have to change that to toggle. That's incredible. Toggle. I can't. Wait. Can I... Game? I want to go into settings. Okay, so run. Oh, it's not under. Oh! We have more keep binding. Well, yeah, this is fine. Wait. I don't think it's in key bindings, it's in... Configuration? No, that's the... Sorry guys, I just have to fix this unless we're gonna blow up. Sprint controls, hold. Yes. Back. Okay. Right, so where... There's another one? Or is this the same one we already looked at? And we need Z and X. Axial... Okay, that's fine then. What's up there? Wait. There's another one. Isn't there? There's something... Or is that just... Oh. Never mind, that's a thingy. I don't know what to say. It's just showing that we have one. That should go away. If I've already, you know, looked at it. All the others did. I'm missing something, obviously. I can't run through there, although I have room to do so. Let's... God, get me up there. The controls are really wonky. Z. That's all I see, is that one. Is there somewhere else I can go? Wait, what's this? We looked at that already, didn't we? It just went away. Wait. I pressed the wrong thing.
Relay 2C shows damage from a temperature
spike. Okay. I pressed Z instead of X.
Bad relay!
Ryder, can you go reset it?
How? How do I reset it? Am I exiting the scanner now? Oh wait, power terminal. Override.
There! It's reset!
Do it! Rerouting the current now!
Should I get away from this thing?
Thank God. It could have been the end of everyone in the cryo bay.
Oh, it's a good thing I finally figured out what to do.
Good job, Ryder. Now we can get to the tram.
Oh goody, tram.
Pull the bridge and tell Captain Dunn this won't hold for long. We're using duct tape and rubber bands here.
I was about to tell you to use duct tape. Duct tape, man. Fixes everything. Alright, so I just want to look around here to see if there's anything I can grab. Or people to talk to. It doesn't seem to be anyone I can talk to in here. Whoa, stutters. Hello up there. Cora is waiting patiently. And seems to be very patient. Yeah, I don't think there's anything here. Okay. So I'm going to sign off here. Well, she looks funky in this light. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, where hopefully we're not so stuttery like this. We are 87% at this time. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode. And endure. In enduring, cross strong.